The quality of the animation in this trailer is bonkers, with one glaring exception, and that's the darn dinosaurs. I just can't wrap my head around why Pixar would want to go for an ultra-realistic approach with the landscapes, but then a super cartoony approach with the lead characters that they're putting in said landscapes. I mean, I guess if Pixar can do what they can do with the landscapes, I don't blame them for wanting to show off. I mean, that opening shot of the leaves and the rain just blew my mind. But then it raises my hopes up so high that they come crashing down when that dinosaur comes into frame. Now, I know that dinosaur is supposed to sell toys, and I know he's supposed to be adorable, but they just don't fit together. That little human boy seems to fit a little bit better into the landscapes, but that green, bright green, hot green dinosaur, neon green, just does not work. And it's a shame, because I think, with the exception of the dinosaurs, everything else in this trailer is a vast improvement on the teaser trailer for the Good Dinosaur, although that was in really good shape until the dinosaurs showed up as well. I think that the idea of a boy and a dinosaur being best friends is a really good one, right? I mean, everyone loves the classic tale of a boy and his dog. So I think that, the high concept pitch here is a boy and his dinosaur, and I think that's really good. And I think it looks like they might be hitting some really good emotional beats here, that they're earning instead of emotionally manipulating us, which of course is one of my chief problems with Pixar these days. I don't think they did that in the early days of their filmmaking with Monsters, Inc., Finding Nemo, The Incredibles, the first Toy Story film. But I think today Pixar is very much in the emotional button-pushing business. But I do see a lot of like really good moments here, and again, I like the setup and I like the idea, and man, always the most aggressive, even when dinosaurs have evolved more so. I thought that was like a funny thing at the end when the little boy takes on that weird snake thing. But I still feel that based on everything that we're seeing, that this is like the dinosaur equivalent of Cars. Well, I think a lot of us would like to see it be the dinosaur equivalent of Finding Nemo. So we'll see where on that sliding scale it lands. But I do think this is an improvement. I like the music choice. And by the way, I think it's very interesting they aren't having really any dialogue, because they totally recast the voice actors for this film just recently, actually. So I bet they're still doing their voice recording and still having to match it to the film itself. So one of the fun reasons behind the scenes as to why you don't hear anyone really talk here. But I'm curious, what do you think? How do you think this movie's developing? And what do you think of Pixar today versus Pixar when it first captured our hearts? Do you see a difference as I do? Or are you like, you're crazy, it's either the same or it's just getting better? And finally, what do you think of the really big deviation in, between the landscape and the characters, and that one is really realistic and one is very cartoony? All right, thank you so much for tuning into my trailer review, and you can check out some other episodes right now.